In our previous videos, we have been elaborately discussing about corrosion, its mechanism, and various types of corrosion. What is corrosion? Corrosion is nothing but destruction of the metal. And when this destruction happens, when the metal is in contact with the environment. So when we are thinking about the term corrosion, right? So the two things that has to come to your mind is, one is the metal and the other one is the environment. So when you are going to discuss about the factors influencing corrosion, right? So what are the factors that are going to influence corrosion? It has to be either the nature of the metal or nature of the environment. Now coming over here, so we have two factors, majorly two factors which are going to affect the, influence the rate of corrosion. One is the nature of the metal and the other one is nature of the environment. Under nature of the metal, we are going to discuss about some 7 points, right? So the first one is the position in the galvanic series. Number two, purity of the metal. Number three, hydrogen over voltage. Number four, relative areas of anode and cathode. Number five, physical state of metals. Number six, nature of the surface film. Number seven, nature of the corrosion product. When you are coming to the nature of the environment, we will be discussing about the factors such as temperature, pH, humidity, presence of corrosive gases and presence of suspended impurities. Now let us explain these factors one by one. Coming over here, position in the galvanic series. When we were discussing about that galvanic corrosion, right? So when, what is galvanic corrosion? When two dissimilar metals are electrically connected and dipped in an electrolyte, right? One metal will act as anode and get corroded and the other metal will act as cathode and remain unaffected. So we have to identify, we have to know which metal will act as anode and undergo corrosion and which metal will undergo or will act as cathode and remain unaffected. For knowing, for getting the knowledge, we have to refer a series called as the electrochemical series or galvanic series, right? So we know that the metal which is higher in the galvanic series will act as anode and get corroded, and the metal will in the lower in the series will act as cathode and remain unaffected. So this is what we have studied in the under galvanic corrosion. So coming over here, if you are having two dissimilar metals which is farther in the electrochemical series, that is one is at the top and one it is the lower, when the difference between these two metals are more in the electrochemical series or galvanic series, right, the rate of corrosion will be more. And if they are nearby, if they are nearer in the galvanic series, then the rate of corrosion will be less. Therefore, when we are selecting the metal for any purpose, then we have to see to that the metals are nearer in the series and they should not be farther in the series. So this is regarding the position in the galvanic series. Right? Now, let us know about the purity of the metal. So it is understood that impurity present in the metal causes heterogeneity in the system, right? Suppose say, let us take for example, let us take the zinc metal, right? Let us take the zinc metal. And in this zinc metal, iron is present as an impurity. A small amount of iron is present as an impurity, right? So because of this presence of the impurity metal, heterogeneity is created in the system. Heterogeneity is created. Heterogeneity means it is not homogeneous. It is not same, right? Some heterogeneity is created in the system. And this heterogeneity will cause the galvanic cell setup in the system. And therefore, the region of the metal around this impurities, the region of the metal around the impurities will be getting destructed. So we have to see to that, that heterogeneity is not created in the system by the presence of impurities. So impurities in the present in the system will enhance the rate of corrosion. So that is the second one. Then third one is the hydrogen over voltage. Hydrogen over voltage. So it has been experimentally proved that the decrease in hydrogen over voltage increases the rate of corrosion. I'll repeat once again, the decrease in hydrogen over voltage increases the rate of corrosion. So before explaining this, how it increases and all such stuff, so let us know what is hydrogen over voltage. Right, it is nothing but it is defined as, hydrogen over voltage is defined defined as the difference in the potential of the electrode in which the gas evolution is actually happening and this theoretical value, the difference between the actual experimental evolution of gas, the potential at which the gas evolution actually observed, and the theoretical value is called as the overvoltage, and if it is involved in the hydrogen evolution, it is called as the hydrogen overvoltage. So let us not go into the details, just for understanding what is what is hydrogen overvoltage. Now coming over here, we say that the decrease in hydrogen overvoltage increases the rate of corrosion. Decrease in hydrogen overvoltage increases the rate of corrosion. Now we will give an example for this. Suppose say I am having a zinc metal, right? I am having a zinc metal, and this is immersed in sulfuric acid. This is immersed in sulfuric acid. Now the overvoltage of the system, hydrogen overvoltage of the system is found to be 0.7 volt. What we have seen, we have taken zinc rod that is immersed in sulfuric acid, and now the electrode potential is found and the overvoltage is found to be 0.7 volt. Right. So to the same system, now you add small amount of copper sulfate. When you add small amount of copper sulfate, right, the rate of corrosion of the zinc metal is found to increase. Corrosion of the metal increases. So then they have analyzed why the corrosion of the metal increases, and when they measure the overvoltage, now after adding this copper sulfate, the overvoltage is found to be 0.33 volt. So thus we prove that the decrease in overvoltage increases the rate of corrosion. So that is the another factor influencing the rate of corrosion. Clear? Now coming to the fourth point, relative areas of anode and cathode. This also we have discussed in our previous videos, right? The rate of corrosion depends upon the relative areas of anode and cathode. I'll repeat once again, the rate of corrosion depends upon the relative areas of anode and cathode. Suppose say the anode cathodic region is having more surface, or cathodic region is more, then corrosion is found to be more. Why cathodic region is more and corrosion is found to be more? So if the cathodic region is more, it will have a more tendency to get the electrons. Therefore the anodic region is compelled to give the electrons. Therefore, it is said that when the cathodic area is more, the rate of corrosion is more, right? So this is the relative areas of anode and the cathode, right? So coming over to the fifth point, which is the physical state of the metals. The physical state of the metal also influences the rate of corrosion. So we have already discussed under stress corrosion, right? So when we are discussing about stress corrosion, we have been discussing that the metal parts under stress will act as anode and get corroded, and the metal parts not under stress will act as cathode and remain unaffected. So we have also seen an example of when iron wire is hammered at the middle, right, the middle part will be getting more stress, therefore it acts as anode, and therefore destruction happens in the middle part, it is split into two, right? So stress corrosion is nothing but the metal part under stress will act as anode and undergo destruction. The metal part which is not under stress will act as cathode and remain unaffected. So, and the other thing is that, so when the grain size of the metal is small, right, when the grain size of the metal is small, again corrosion will happen in the metal. So the parts which are stressed are also undergoing corrosion, and if the metal is having small grain size also, it will undergo corrosion to a greater extent. Therefore physical state of the metal is also very, very important in influencing the rate of corrosion. So this is what we are seeing under physical state of the metal. Clear? Now, sixth one is the nature of the surface film. This also we have discussed in our previous video. In dry corrosion, right? Atmospheric gases like hydrogen, oxygen, halogens, they attack the surface of the metal, resulting in the formation of a metal oxide film. And this metal oxide film can act as a protective layer and prevent further corrosion. Or this metal oxide film can also act as a non-protective layer and further corrosion will happen. So this in under this one, we have also discussed about the Pilling-Bedworth rule, right? In the metals like calcium, magnesium and sodium, the volume of the metal oxide formed is less than the volume of the metal. Therefore, it forms a non-protective layer which is porous in nature, and in those cases further corrosion is happening. Whereas in the case of aluminium, nickel and chromium, right, the metal oxide formed, the volume of the metal oxide is greater than the volume of the metal from which it is formed. This we have discussed under Pilling-Bedworth rule. In such metals, the metal oxide that is formed will be acting as a protective layer and further corrosion will not happen. So this nature of the metal oxide film also influences the rate of corrosion or the corrosion phenomenon. If it is non-protective, further corrosion will happen. If it is protective in nature, then further corrosion will not happen in the metal. So this is what we have studied under nature of the surface film. Then the last one is the nature of the corrosion product, right? So when we are discussing about the mechanism of corrosion, the metallic ions that are produced in the anode and non-metallic ions that produce in the cathode, they combine together to give the corrosion product. If the corrosion product is soluble in nature, then further corrosion will happen. And if the corrosion product formed is insoluble in nature, further corrosion will not occur in the metal. So these are the things that we have discussed under the nature of the metal. Right. Now, coming to the nature of the environment, we know first one is the first factor is the temperature, right? When the temperature increases, the rate of corrosion is also increasing. When temperature increases, corrosion will also increase. This is because when the temperature is more, there will be more diffusion of ions, therefore the corrosion rate increases. So this is first one is, when the temperature increases, corrosion rate increases. Right. The second factor is the pH. Right. We know that when the metal is in the acidic environment means what? When the pH is less than 5, right? Corrosion, rate of corrosion will be more. And when the metal is immersed in an alkaline environment, right? When the pH is around 10, 11 or something like that, then the rate of corrosion will be less. So simple example that we can think of is when you take a zinc metal and keep it in an acidic solution, we found that the rate of corrosion is more. When the zinc metal is placed in the alkaline environment, the rate of corrosion is found to be less. So this is about the factor pH, which is influencing the rate of corrosion. Third one is the humidity. Humidity is nothing but the moisture content in the atmosphere. If the atmosphere is more humid, then rate of corrosion will also increase. So this is regarding the humidity. When the humidity increases, corrosion will also increase. Right. Then the fourth factor is the presence of corrosive gases. Right. Suppose the corrosive gases like CO2, SO2, etc. And also fumes like HCl. Right. So they become the solvent for the oxygen and become an electrolyte. And therefore corrosion process is happening due to the formation of H2SO4. Say for example, if you are having SO2 and it reacts with water to give H2SO4, and similarly Fe plus H2SO4 giving FeSO4. The fifth one is the presence of suspended impurities. So we have some suspended impurities like NaCl, NH4 twice, SO4. So the presence of these suspended impurities in the atmosphere will also increase the rate of corrosion. So this is what we are studying under the presence of suspended impurities. So dear students, in this class we have discussed about the factors influencing corrosion, which is one related to the nature of the metal and the other related to the nature of the environment. That's it for today. We'll see you in the next class. Thank you.